greetings from just off Orwell Lane. A spectral monk extracting vengeance against a church committee is the primary backdrop for the second on-the-air foray of Bill Johnstone as Lamont Cranston, a.k.a. The Shadow. This episode was actually originally slated to be the debut for Season 2, but the scripts were switched at the last minute. Penned by veteran writer, producer, and playwright Jerry Devine, it is a fairly straightforward whodunit-style mystery, and follows a formulaic pattern that would become especially identifiable during later seasons when Devine was the primary scriptwriter. Check your belfry for angry spirits in anticipation of The Black Abbot from October 2nd, 1938.
The Shadow, who aids the forces of law and order, is in reality Lamont Cranston, wealthy young man about town. Years ago in the Orient, Cranston learned a strange and mysterious secret. The hypnotic power to cloud men's minds so they cannot see him. Cranston's friend and companion, the lovely Margot Lane, is the only person who knows to whom the voice of the invisible shadow belongs. Today's story, The Black Abbot.
How does this carving look, Mike?
Okay. Say, what time is it?
That's a little after midnight.
You know, I don't like this much, working in a church in the nighttime. It just don't seem right.
Well, it's got to be done. The whole inside of this place has to be restored by the end of next month.
Yeah, but I hate working nights to do it. I get a creepy feeling. It's so quiet here.
What are you expecting? Ghosts?
Nah. It's just... Hey, Joe. What's that?
What?
Somebody coming down the aisle of the church.
Oh, stop it, will you? It's probably one of...
Look at him. Short-breasted and black. Like a monk.
One of the ministers, I guess.
He's coming right at us. That ain't no minister.
Yeah, I guess it ain't.
Look at that face. Hey, let's get away from here. Come on, come on.
Gentlemen, gentlemen, silence, please. Thank you. We have called this special meeting of the Church Finance Committee at the specific request of Mr. Paul Randolph, the architect in charge of the reconstruction of our church. A problem has arisen which has considerably delayed his efforts. I'll let him tell you about it himself. Mr. Randolph, if you please.
Thank you, Mr. Miller. Gentlemen, for the past week, the workmen who are restoring the ancient stone carvings in the interior of the church have positively refused to do any work. Any amount of coaxing has failed to change their minds.
What is their reason for this attitude?
Just this. They say that the church is haunted.
Haunted?
Well, now, I'm merely repeating the facts that have been told to me. My workmen swear they have seen the black-robed figure of a monk stalking through the aisles of the church.
Oh, this is ridiculous, Mr. Randolph. Have you yourself ever seen this, this vision?
No, I haven't.
Good heavens, do you men realize the great harm that this can do the church? Fortunately, gentlemen, we may still have time to dispel it.
How?
By several of us spending the night in the church and disproving once and for all this nonsense about a ghost. I will gladly be one of the volunteers in this experiment. Will anyone join me?
I will, Philip.
I will. Of course, I will.
Well, I think there need only be two of us. I'll select Mr. Williams to accompany me.
When will you visit the church, Mr. Phillips?
Tonight, Randolph. We'll visit the church tonight.
Philip. Is it? Huh? What? Oh, sorry, William. I must have dozed off. It just struck three. Still no sign of our black-robed friend, eh?
No.
I thought not. Now you see how these stories come about.
Oh, what's that?
Don't be so jumpy, Williams. It's nothing but the wind.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure.
Look, Phillips, don't you think we've been here in the church long enough to prove that the whole story is untrue?
We're staying here until morning. Now brace up, Williams. There's nothing to fear.
Listen. That isn't the wind.
No. Someone's playing the organ.
I don't like this.
Don't be a fool, Williams. Come quickly. We'll find out who it is.
No.
Come on.
Seated at the keyboard.
I don't understand it.
And yet it continues to play.
Yes.
Let's get out of here, please, Philip. Please.
No, we're going to stay. We've got to learn what this is all about.
Stop. Come on. Can't we go and get the others and then come back?
No, we must investigate this now.
Look! Coming down the aisle of the church.
A black-robed figure.
The Black Abbot.
He's coming toward us.
I can't stand this, Philip. I can't stand it.
Come back here, Williams. Come back here.
No, I'm going. Williams!
You have been left alone, John Phillips.
You can't fight me. Who are you?
I am the true abbot of this church.
Keep away from me.
You have desecrated my church, John Phillips. And by solitary, you must pay for your sin.
No. No, keep away, I say.
Hey, do you hear?
No.
Who is it?
I must see the rector at once.
Why, Mr. Williams.
Yes, Mr. Miller, please.
What's the trouble down there?
It's me, Williams, Mr. Miller. Will you come down quickly, please?
What's happened, Williams?
The abbot. The Black Abbot. We just saw him in the church. I came as fast as I could.
No, calm yourself.
Where is Mr. Phillips? He's still in the church. We must go to him at once. He's alone with the abbot. The bells at the church.
That's strange. Phillips must be ringing for help. We'll go to him at once.
Committee has mysteriously disappeared.
That's right, Mr. Cranston. And I believe that somewhere at the bottom of all this is this ghost called the Black Abbot. Knowing of your reputation, I've come to you.
How long is it since the body of Phillips was found?
About a month, Miss Lane.
These three disappearances. Was there any clue as to where the men were last seen?
Yes. In each case, they were somewhere in the vicinity of the church.
I see. And how long have they been missing?
Different periods, Mr. Cranston. The last one was less than a week ago.
Lamont, do you suppose that they've met the same fate as Phillips? Do you suppose they met the Black Abbot?
I don't know, Margot.
So far, we've been able to keep the true facts of this mystery from the newspapers. But we can't do it much longer.
I realize that.
Mr. Cranston, the work of the church is at a standstill, and it will never be completed unless these disappearances and Phillips' deaths are explained. You must help us. Please.
Well, I don't know how much I can find out for you, Mr. Miller. I should be glad to do what I can.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Now, if you want any further information or assistance, you can call on me at the rectory.
Very well, I shall do that.
Good day. Good day, Miss Lane.
Goodbye, Mr. Miller.
Goodbye.
What do you make of all this, Lamont?
I don't know yet, Margot. But there's only one way to find out.
How?
By spending a night in the church. There is a so-called Black Abbot. I believe there's a way to deal with him.
How?
I can't tell you just now. You see, that will be a job for me as the Shadow.
Tell the rector about what happened last night in the church?
No, Margot. I thought it best not to mention it to anyone for the present. One thing is certain after last evening's encounter, however.
But what?
Our elusive Black Abbot proved himself to be a very human ghost.
Yes.
But who he is and what his motive might be still remains to be discovered.
And how he got away.
Yes. That's the first thing to find out. Well, here we are. Mm. We'll leave the car right here. Come along, Margot.
It's altogether different in the daytime, doesn't it?
Yes, quite. Oh, I believe this door is open. Yes, there it is. Shall we go in?
Yes. What shall we examine first, Lamont? The belfry?
No. I'd rather have a look at the wall. I have an idea that there's some secret doorway in the paneling through which the abbot made his getaway.
That would be here, wouldn't it?
Yes. I'll look down by the organ, so. If you find anything suspicious, call me.
Yes, I will, Lamont. This panel is solid. No false projections.
Good afternoon.
Oh!
I'm so sorry. Did I frighten you?
Well, it's quite all right. I just didn't hear you coming.
Please accept my apology. I'm Paul Randolph, the architect in charge here.
Oh, how do you do? I'm Margot Lane.
Oh, Miss Lane.
Oh, Lamont, will you come here?
Yes, coming.
Mr. Cranston, this is Mr. Randolph, the architect of the church.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Mr. Randolph.
Thank you. May I be of any assistance to you?
Well, I don't suppose so. You see, we've just been testing our curiosity.
Oh, how's that?
Well, we've heard something of the so-called ghost that's supposed to be here, and we believe that ghosts always use secret passageways and such, and we were just looking for one.
Oh, I see.
Of course, this has all been done with the rector's permission.
Naturally.
Oh, Mr. Randolph, as architect, you no doubt have the original plans of this church, haven't you?
Of course.
Do you suppose they might indicate any secret passages?
Oh, I've never noticed. But I'd be glad to have you look at them.
Well, splendid.
Well, you may see them tonight if you wish. I'll bring them to you.
Thank you.
Suppose we meet tonight. Here. In the church.
Lamont, do you think Mr. Randolph will keep his word?
Oh, yes, Margot. He'll be here.
I shouldn't like to spend more nights here, Lamont, even though I know that the abbot is not a ghost. It's so frightening being alone in this great church.
Well, if all goes as I expect.
Lamont, listen. Hear those footsteps?
Yes.
Can it be the abbot again?
We'll soon find out.
Mr. Randolph.
Hello there. Sorry to be late.
That's all right, Randolph.
You gave us quite a scare.
That seems to be a habit with me, doesn't it?
Did you bring the plans?
Yes, two copies. Here's one for you.
Oh, thanks. Well, let's get to work. We can each start at one end of the wall, Randolph.
Very well.
Oh, Margot, you come with me.
Yes.
Well, Mr. Cranston, I wonder if Miss Lane would mind accompanying me instead.
Well,
you see, my eyesight is rather poor, and in this darkness, I...
Well, all right, I'll go with you, Mr. Randolph.
Good. Here are the plans. And here's my flashlight, Miss Lane.
Thanks.
Call out to me if you find anything.
Oh, yes, surely, Mr. Grant. We can start right here, Miss Lane.
All right.
Do the plans indicate anything for this section?
Well, there does seem to be one thing here that might mean something. It would be at about this point on the wall.
Where?
This little cornerstone. Look, Mr. Randolph. It moves.
Why, so it does.
I'll turn it down all the way. The panel is opening. We must call them on.
Shut up!
Let me go!
Stop, I say. You found the secret. Now you must share it with me.
No! No!
Come on, come on!
No! 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 Help me!
Up those stairs, Miss Lane.
Why are you taking me?
You'll see in a minute.
Why are you doing this? I thought you were helping us.
I am helping you. You were seeking the Black Abbot, weren't you?
Yes.
Weren't you? And I am taking you to him.
No. No.
Go through that door.
I won't.
Then I shall have to carry you through.
Take your hand off him. I'll go.
That's very sensible. Here we are.
Where are we?
If you must know exactly, we are safely hidden between the vaulted ceiling and the outer roof of the church. You'll excuse me if I lock the door. Just as a precaution. There.
You said you were taking me to the Black Abbot. Where is he?
You're quite anxious to meet him, aren't you? Very well. Hand me that robe.
You! You're the Black Abbot.
I am.
Lamont!
Go on, scream! Scream louder! No one will hear you.
Lamont!
glass as these walls. I want you to meet some of the congregation. Here they are. These are the gentlemen of the church committee who disappeared so mysteriously.
They're dead.
Yes. Quite dead.
Oh, horrible.
But tonight they shall be entertained. Tonight they shall witness the arrival of a new member of their group. Yes, you. Now, come here.
No! No, you can't do this! No!
Oh, I see I'll have to use force. I shall have to bind you.
No, take that rope away. You're hurting me.
You won't feel the pain for long. Soon you will join the others.
You don't know what you're doing.
Prepare yourself for the sacrifice, Miss Lane. The service is about to begin.
Please let me go. Please.
First, the music. The greatest of all honors. Make yourself ready for the beauties of the death that is about to befall you.
But she isn't going to die, Black Abbot.
You? Where are you?
I am right here beside you. Unbind that girl.
How did you get here?
Just as you did.
But the door, it's still locked.
I came in with you. In the shadows.
So that's who you are. The shadow.
Yes.
You're very clever, Shadow. But not clever enough to outwit me.
We shall see. But first, unbind that girl.
No, no. She must die. She knows the abbot's secret.
After tonight, everyone will know the abbot's secret. Paul Randolph. You are Paul Randolph.
Yes. Yes, that's who I am. I don't care if you do know it, because neither of you will ever live to tell it.
You're wrong, Randolph. We both shall live. And you will be turned over to the police for the murders of the church committeemen.
And how do you propose to do that?
You shall see. Why did you murder these men? Why?
I'll tell you. Buried within these walls are many priceless relics. No one knows of them but me. And when I have disposed of all who stand in my way, they'll be mine. Mine, do you hear? And no one shall take them from me. That's why I steal those men. I hung Phillips as a warning to keep them away. But they were fools. I learned my secret. That's why you both must die, too.
You heard his confession, Margot?
Yes.
You'll never live to repeat it.
He has a knife.
Drop that, Randolph.
Oh, no. If you attempt to come near me, Shadow, I'll plunge this into a heart.
No, you won't.
Let go of my arm.
Not that drip.
No. Now let go of it. She must die.
The knife is almost touching me.
I am afraid I'll have to break your arm, Randolph. He's fainted. Yeah. I'll untie your bonds, Margot.
Oh, thank heaven you arrived in time. There's a knot under my shoulder.
Phillips should be repeated.
by fate for his murderer, the Black Abbot. He's fainted. Here, I'll untie your bonds, Margot.
Oh, thank heaven you arrived in time. There's a knot under my shoulder.
Yes,
Ha, 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 ha.